Wait, the way my neighbor's tree literally said Red Taylor's version. Hello? Yes, Queen.
Hello, Swifties. Or non-Swifties. Red Taylor's version is now finally out. It's been out for a few hours now. I did try to wake up for 5 a.m. UK time to listen to it straight away and watch all the interviews, but I simply wasn't giving warning. Red holds very many memories in my heart. Like, removing the original, the stolen Red from my Spotify playlists and whatever. I still have like physical copy of it and stuff, but removing it physically from the Spotify liked songs, liked albums thing, it hurt. Like, it actually hurt. But yeah, it was 2012. I was 17 when Red came out. I remember the like the rollout for it, for the countdown, and like she released like one song every week for a month before the release. I remember that. I remember when We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together was released and the music video. I was actually in Indonesia. It was my sister's wedding that September, and we were there for the whole of August to visit family and everything. And I remember seeing the music video drop for the first time, like on my cousin's TV. It was also like that year, that summer, was when I first got Instagram. And I'm pretty sure Taylor was the first person I followed, if not my sister. So I witnessed the whole like her counting down the days and putting all these posts, being like, oh my God, one more day till Red, and this is the final day of my life before Red. Speak Now is probably just marginally more of my favorite above Red. But they both hold really dear places in my heart because I was a teenager at the time. Those were the albums that I'd like waited for. I was there for like the release, the rollout, the promo of it all, and like I listened to them constantly. Just as a side note as well, Enchanted kind of trending on TikTok and everywhere and like becoming number one on certain charts. Like, that's insane to me because that's my favorite song of all time. I remember listening to, like, I would listen to that song at least 3 times daily from the years of 2010 till the release of Red, probably, and even then I still listen to it all the time. But yeah, Red, like Speak Now was the first album I bought for myself and like waited for, but Red like was the first time I was there for like the release of an album, you know? Like, Speak Now just kind of happened and I knew about it, but Red was, there was a build-up. There was like this, the way that she announced it, what, like 5 months ago or something? And now we finally have it. So I've listened to the whole album up until Ronan, actually, because I felt like I didn't really want to react to Ronan, because I don't know, it just felt really like, not disrespectful per se, but it didn't quite feel right to, you know, like react. And oh my goodness, like with Fearless, Taylor's version, I feel like it mostly sounded the same. It was just kind of like more mature vocals, like she's not 18. And there was a few like inflections that were different and little bits of production that were a bit more elevated, I suppose. But Red, I feel like, feels distinct. Like, it's the same, but not the same. Like, a lot of it, the new version of The Last Time, which is one of my favorites off Red, oh, breathtaking. Gary Lightbody sounds so good. The same with like the new version of Everything Has Changed. Why does it feel like it's the same, but it's not, and it feels better? Like, they sound better. The new version of Girl at Home, I will say, the girl bossification of it all. Oh, and all the memories just came flooding back as I was listening to it. Like, I like actually went through a breakup at the time, guys, when Red First was released. So I really like related all the songs. Like, All Too Well, of course. I think I'm gonna do All Too Well 10-minute version separate to this. This is just gonna be like the new songs. Like, new song. Like, I'd somehow forgotten how early in the listing I Knew Your Trouble was, and it just hit me like a ton of bricks. Like, oh my God, this was that era. I Knew You Were Trouble was the like the bonus, like the surprise acoustic song when I went to see the Reputation tour in Manchester as well. Treacherous was one of my favorite songs. I remember really distinctly, like, me and my friend Becky were talking about our favorites off Red. Like in the sixth form common room, and I was saying I really like Treacherous. And our friend Ellie, who's also a big Taylor Swift fan at the time, I think she didn't realize that we were talking about songs, and she thought we were talking about like our favorite words. And she's, I've forgotten what word she said, but she was like, oh yeah, I really like Archaic. And we were just like, bestie. 22. Iconic. Imagine owning an entire age. I had a Feeling 22 cake topper. My hair was red. I had a fringe. It was a whole thing. Red, the song herself, I remember making for the 2015 UK general election with Ed Miliband and David Cameron. I made a series of vines that went semi-viral of Ed Miliband to the chorus of Red. I also then remembered like the B.O.B. song, Both of Us, featuring Taylor Swift. Like, that entire era was so wholesome. I talk about this a lot with, like, people I know. But, like, things just didn't seem as doom and gloom, and everything was a little bit kind of, like, chill. And, like, we were doing YouTube challenges and just silly little things. I remember I went on a tour around Europe with my family, and I did karaoke, and I sang I Knew You Were Trouble, and then I also sang Holy Ground. Ah, oh, what a time, what a time. It's also just, like, sad girl autumn peak hours. I have two comfort albums for autumn, which is my favorite season, and that is Red, now Taylor's version, and Mono by RM. Okay, so anyway, enough of that. Let's get into the new songs. First one is Better Man, I think, in the listing. And we have heard that before because she wrote it for Little Big Town, but she did like an acoustic set of it. I forgot where, but I really like that and I can't wait to hear her version of it. I have Jungle Scar here, by the way. My sweet boy. I named him Eggs Benedict. Okay, yeah, so the first new one is Better Man, Taylor's version. Okay, production. I know I'm probably better off on my own than loving a man who didn't know what he had when he had it. The vocal. Softer than I was expecting. Like, it's very country. To say, like, this is gorgeous. I really love the Little Big Town version, but this is, I mean, it's Taylor. Vocal. Oh, there it is. Oh, there it is. I was waiting for that. Why didn't she release this originally? Okay, next, actually, we have the new song, which is called Nothing New, that features Phoebe Bridges, and like, there was some interview or whatever where she talks about singing her verse and how she like teared up. Does this mean she has a verse? Is she the first woman to actually have a verse in a Taylor Swift song and not just be like backing vocal? They tell you while you're young. Straight away. Lord, what will become of me? Once I've lost my novelty. Is this like the lucky one? How can a person know everything at 18? And we still won't be when I'm nothing new. Oh. How long will it be cute? All this crying in my room when you can't blame it on my youth and more. You know, I really feel that one. This is sad. But what did I expect? And a chorus. I love that part. But feel time moving. This is beautiful. There's something about Taylor and another singer like doing a back and forth. Very Betty, not Betty, Cardigan. Oh, that was cute. That was pretty. That was emotional. Actually, yeah, that was very Cardigan. Like when you're nothing new. Like when you're an old Cardigan, but you're still the favorite. Much to think about. Oh my god, Phoebe, go off though. Like, Taylor, collab with more female vocalists. Also, Phoebe Bridges collabed with Taylor Swift. She previously collabed with the 1975. Taylor Swift, 1975. When? Next, we have Babe, which is also actually not a new song. She did it for Sugarland, and I also really love their version. I love the music video with Taylor in her like red wig being the mistress. She teased on Tumblr of all places, like a little snippet of it, and it sounds new. There's something about promises, and that wasn't in the original, the Sugarland version. So I'm excited. Can I just say that sounded so 90s? It's giving TLC. I do really love the intro on the original version, like the guitar sounds so nice on the start, but this is new. Also, I got that wrong. Am I thinking of TLC? I think I'm thinking of Three Little Women, 3LW. It's giving me No More by Three Little Women. I'm getting a little tired of your broken promises, looking at your pages, seeing different numbers. I'm here on the kitchen door. You call, but I won't hear it. You said no one else. How could you do this? Taking down the pictures and the plans we made. Yeah, consequence, and that's on you, babe. Break down every time you call. We'll break you the wrecking ball. We said no one else. How could you do this, babe? This is a bop. Like, bop. I'm ready. Arrived. I think I don't know what else this could be. Look at the shape. Look at it. She really meant it when she said it would be ready for today. Oh, she's everything. I mean, look at her. She's gorgeous, Your Honor. Oh my goodness, whoa! Ugh, let's take out one of the vinyls. How gorgeous is that red? Look at that. I really wanted the Target exclusive, like, actual red vinyls, but with the shipping and then, like, probably the... what's it called? The extra bit? Customs? It would have been pretty expensive. Cute. Oh my goodness, how cute. Oh, how... I'm in love. To be honest, actually, like, the black with the red middle, very classic looking. I'm a big fan. Okay, I'm just gonna leave her there. Next, we have another new one. Message in a Bottle. This is completely new. No features, just Taylor. Now tell me why I wasn't expecting that at all. Oh, very boppy. That's very different to Red, but also not at the same time. Like, it's very of that era for her. You know what it reminds me of, the kind of production, is Sweeter Than Fiction, which I thought was going to be on this, but I guess not. Hmm. Like, that was definitely... Was that Jack Antonoff's first collab with Taylor? Oh, so true, sis. Like, this is definitely a dance around your room with a hairbrush. It's very cute. Oh, London. Come Back, Be Here. The high note. That was fun. That was so fun. Next we have I Bet You Think About Me, featuring Chris Stapleton. He's also gonna feature on Adele's album, I think. Get that coin. 3 a.m. and I'm still awake. Oh, country. Of course. Better than me. Oh! Oh, comes through country. Comes through Nashville. Ooh. Oh, I love this. I bet you think about me. I can just imagine him being like, I bet you think about me. I love this so much. The country instrumentals. Change. It seems that Chris does not have a verse. He is just backing vocal. The serve. I simply have to scream. Now we have Forever Winter. He says he doesn't believe anything that she hears these days. Ooh. He says, why fall in love just so you can watch it go? I like the cadence. He's up 3 a.m. pacing. Oh. Oh, that's pretty. Oh, I really like this one. I pull at every thread, trying to solve the puzzles in his head. Live my life scared to death, he'll decide to leave instead. Sis was really sitting on this for 9 years. Echo as that fades. I really like the instrumental on this. Like, the production's really pretty. Oh, head voice is so nice. I like the drum. Oh. Oh, I like that. It's really big, big production at the end. Oh, I love that one. That was wonderful. I really like that. I like the rhythm of it. I like the cadence and the verses. Oh, the big production at the end. I think it was trumpets or some sort of brass in the background. It was like, bum, bum, bum. Oh, so nice. Next, we have Run featuring Ed Sheeran, Edward Sheeran, the bestie Ed, Ed bestie, Estee. Now, supposedly they wrote this one before Everything Has Changed. But they never released it. But Ed was saying that he really liked it and was like hoping that at some point they'd be able to release it in some way. So now they can. Give me the keys. I'll bring the car back around. We shouldn't be in this town. There's a chain round your throat, piece of paper where I wrote, I'll wait for you. There's a key on the chain, there's a picture in a frame, take it with you. Oh, that's so pretty. Yes. This is my favorite Ed Sheeran. These kind of songs. This is like a really soft and like sweet version. I was just gonna say, it's like a nice, soft, and a sweeter version of I Know Places. That was really nice. I like that. That's such a good, like, showcase of both of their talents. I can't lie, I do like Everything Has Changed, but I think I just like the style of that song more. It definitely, it was a good choice to go with that over Run, because I think it's very radio friendly. I think the locals, the general public ate that up. The music video was also very cute. I don't know if it's just the nostalgia. Like, me and my sister used to sing Everything Has Changed all the time. Like, we did so many covers of it just in her room. I would always do the Ed Sheeran harmony because I could always do the lower ones. God, Red Album really has a grip on my life. Like, it shaped me into who I am today. No, it's true. Literally, for my other sister, I burned her a Red CD, like, so that she could listen to it without me, basically. So she could have this CD in her car. I could definitely see, though, a lot of people preferring Run over Everything Has Changed. Everything Has Changed is very, I think, quite commercial. Okay, the last one before the 10-minute version of All Too Well is The Very First Night. I wish I could fly high. I'd pick you up and we go back in time. And so it goes, every weekend the same party. Okay, I'm getting a lot of, I guess, like, the latter part of the album as well. So, no, I get, okay, mainly, so a lot of these vault tracks give me, like I said before, Sweeter Than Fiction, but if referring specifically to Red, Starlight, like, the production and the instrumentals and kind of, like, the heavier pop aspect of it, but with a lot of like a lot of drums, you know, that kind, that the bigger production, like it's really reminiscent of Starlight. I wonder if that was kind of the direction that she was going with some parts of Red. Like even Red, the song itself, is a bit more of that, but like with a lot more of the like the rock like guitars. This is very pop. In the same way that Starlight and Sweeter Than Fiction is, and Message in a Bottle is like that, her version of Babe, and Forever Winter, and now this, The Very First Night. It's, I guess, it's kind of like the intermediate between Red and 1989, maybe, but 1989 was like 80s pop inspired. Much to think about. The drums. Very first night. Oh, I like this. Oh my gosh, that's all the vault tracks. From the vault tracks, I think my favorites are Nothing New, the Phoebe Bridgers one. I Bet You Think About Me with Chris Stapleton, and Forever Winter. I really love Forever Winter. They were all really nice. The Better Man and Babe, I really like the original ones, and I'm kind of used to them. So I think I'll have to listen to these ones again. They're like different in a good way. But for now, I think I prefer, like, especially Babe. I liked the backing better in Babe, like the echo when Taylor does it on top of their vocals is really, really nice. Forever Winter was just like haunting somehow. I really want to, and then I Bet You Think About Me is so like, it's so country, but like a modern, like really Taylor country. Oh, okay. So yeah. Oh my gosh. That was Red. Anyway, thank you for watching my first listen to the new songs on Red, Taylor's version. I'm very excited. Streets are saying Speak Now is next. She did kind of hint at Hours. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the album as much as I did. Let me know which songs you liked best out of the new ones, or any from the old ones that you now, you know, like it's made a revival for you. Okay, bye.